Initiation to a master. Initiation is the ultimate in the process of transformation. Why is initiation into meditation or initiation to a master essential? He is asleep. Even in his waking, he is asleep. His sleep is neurotic. He cannot wake up from his sleep. On his own, he may wake up, but still remain in slumber. A master is needed to wake him up from such neurosis. Initiation is the process for him to remain in contact with the one who is awakened. You are capable of dreaming even when you are awake. When it is said man is asleep, this has to be understood. Man dreams 24 hours a day. In the night, when we are close to the outer world, we continue to dream. Our senses open in the outer world of duality. It is through the senses that we continue to experience the outer world. But the dreams continue within. Just close your eyes and start dreaming again. Dreams are a continuity inside. You are aware of the outer world, but that awareness is imposed on the dreaming mind. Thus continues the dream. In such a case, we cannot envision reality, although we are awake. This is how dreams are imposed on reality. What we actually see is our projection on reality. Everyone is plagued with dreams. A father is full of his unfulfilled dreams. You become an object of projection for your father. Your father will project his dreams on you. Then whatever he understands about you gets mixed up with his own dreams. So projecting one's dreams on someone else is different than loving. When you love someone, you do not impose your dreams on them. He will appear quite different than when you do not love him. The other becomes quite different when you use the other as a screen to project your dreams. What a father cannot do in his life, he wants to fulfill that through his son, through his children. And this is how you project your dreams on the other as a screen. When someone loves you, the dream is different. Also, that person appears different. On the contrary, when you do not love someone, the person is the same. The screen is also the same, but projection differs. In that case, you are not using the other as the screen to project your dreams. This can change again. Once again, you can love the other and then he will appear different. Normally, we do not see what this is. We go on seeing our own dreams projected in reality. A master is not the same to each one of you. Each one projects something different on the master. In reality, he is one as far as he is concerned. If the master himself is dreaming, then he will differ in each moment. It is so because each moment his interpretation will differ. But when the master is awakened, then he will remain the same in all situations and circumstances. Buddha said the real test of an enlightened one is that he is always the same. He is just like a sea water. Its taste never changes wherever you taste it from. As a person, you are a projection of ideas, notions, conceptions, and interpretations. Like a projector, you go on projecting things that are nowhere but inside you. The whole becomes a screen, then you cannot be aware by yourself. This is a state of deep sleep. I have heard there was a Sufi master, Hijra. One day an angel appeared to him in a dream and told him to save as much water as possible, because the next day the devil will poison all the water and whosoever drank that water would turn mad. So that night the Sufi collected as much water as he could. The phenomena really happened. The next day everyone became mad after drinking the poisoned water. The whole city became mad. No one knew what had happened. It was only the Sufi who was not mad. But everyone thought that the Sufi had become mad. But he knew what had happened. No one believed him. He went on drinking his water and remained sane by himself. However, he could not continue for long in this way. The entire city was living in an altogether different world. And one day the rumor came that he could be caught and put into prison. It was believed that he had gone mad. Finally, one morning they got hold of him. He had two options: either accept treatment for his madness or be prepared to go to prison. He was not allowed freedom. He was condemned as mad. It was based on the conclusion that he spoke a different language that could not be understood by the masses. The Sufi was at a loss. He tried to remind people of their past through every possible means. But the people had forgotten everything. He was incomprehensible to them. So they surrounded his house and caught him. At this, the Sufi asked to be given some time to cure himself. He went to the well and drank some water. As he drank the water, he became one like them. The whole city was happy that the Sufi was cured now. Now his madness was no more. You are asleep, but you are never aware of the sleep. When everyone is mad and you are also mad, you can never be aware of this. Initiation is therefore the way to awaken you from this sleep. Initiation is not a ritual, as it is considered in Islamic tradition that you are initiated by a particular master and you cannot go to any other. Or in Hinduism, by initiation is meant that you have surrendered to someone who is away. And when you surrender, you are not surrendering to any physical being. You are surrendering to the awareness that he represents. You are a part of the world, a part of its duality and its madness. Living in this world, you are always plagued by dreams. Such feelings can also come from someone who is in a sleeping state. Sleep is not always deep. In the beginning, sleep wavers. Sometimes it is deep, at other times it gets shallow. There is a similarity between ordinary sleep and the metaphysical sleep. Ordinary sleep fluctuates between various planes and levels. Metaphysical sleep also fluctuates. At times you are on the borderline. You are very close to being a Buddha. You can then understand something that Buddha is saying. However, whatever is heard or understood is not exactly the same. But you get a glimpse of the truth. It is like looking at the sunrise from a room through a glass window. You are not as yet in openness under the vast sky. The master observes this. A person who is on the borderline of this metaphysical sleep now needs initiation. It needs to be within the energy field of an awakened or enlightened master. He can hear something. He can understand something. He can see something as well. Everything around him is like the mist. Yet still he feels something. Thus he approaches an enlightened one, not really knowing the essence of enlightenment. He is ready to surrender. This is the only way to wake up from this metaphysical sleep, sleep of lives. Only this much this person can do. Surrendering brings the understanding that something other than sleep is now happening. Somehow he feels this. But he cannot exactly know what this is. Whenever an enlightened one passes, those who are on the borderline of this metaphysical sleep can recognize that there is something different about this person. A different breeze, a different energy field surrounds this person. He behaves differently, he speaks differently, he lives differently. He walks differently. Something different has happened to him. He looks like one of us, but in reality he is much more than total human intellect can comprehend. He is the pulse of the unknown. So those who are on the borderline can feel this, but they are asleep. Also, the borderline sleep is transient. They can fall back into sleep anytime.